Welcome to the third chapter of FPDF tutorial series. In this chapter, I'm about to explain how to put an image in PDF, and how to make a header and footer, which will be repeated in every pages. I will start from this improved code from previous tutorial with addition of some dummy data. Now I'm about to add watermark, which is a semi-transparent image placed in background. First, make sure you have a large, semi-transparent image. It have to be a low contrast image, so it won't reduce the visibility of the content. To put image into PDF, we will use FPDF image method with following parameters. Images in PDF is placed by absolute coordinate from upper left corner. And it won't interfere with cells placement. In the case of watermark, we put the image at upper left margin. And then we need to set the width to fit paper boundaries. Now we are about to add header and footer. In order to add header and footer, we need to extend the FPDF class and add header and footer method. We put the header content inside header, and footer inside footer. Header and footer can consist of cells, text, and images. And it will be repeated on each pages. Header will be rendered at the beginning of pages, and footer at the end of page. Here, I will use alternative, shorter way to make dummy cells. For the notice, any image in either header and footer can be positioned on any part of the page. Because images is positioned by absolute coordinate from page's upper left corner. Now let's add footer. As I said before, footer is rendered after the end of page. Which means it will be positioned after last cell in the page. In order to place the footer at absolute bottom of the page, we need to use set y method and set the parameter to -15. This means the content of footer will be placed 15 mm from bottom of the y or vertical axis. Page no method will return integer of current page number. Always remember, in header and footer, we use $ this variable. In order to add total page number, we need to use alias nbpages. This method is to define a string alias for total number of pages. It will substitute as the document is closed. And replace the defined string within document with total page numbers. In this example, I used pages enclosed in curly braces as an alias. And always put alias and pages between object definition and addPage method. This concludes this chapter of tutorial. Thank you for watching. See you in the next chapter.